Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. There's Sarah Morgan, she's reading the label here. About caution. Very good, to be cautious and... all that. Let's go to the residential section. Oops. Hi.
Nothing like living under the light of our original sun.
The original sun.
Sorry, yeah. Can't talk.
Why are you staring at me? Lux Condominiums. Mitch Benjamin.
Consider this unit always on the job. Worker robot coming through.
Huh.
Kinda in the middle of something here.
Citizens. Alright, so when we get stutters like that, it can lead to audio-video desync, which is why I restart the recording sometimes when I get a couple stutters. Like that. So it just resets the audio and video correctly. Let's talk to this guy, Mitch Benjamin.
Hey! Haven't seen you around here before. Did you just move in?
Can we lie? Yeah, we can lie. I don't want to see what the reason is to just lie to random people. I mean, it's tempting, but I don't know what the motive for my character would be. Just a troublemaker? A liar? I mean, obviously. But like a... somebody has an issue with telling the truth about anything. No, I'm just visiting.
Visiting Cydonia?
What the hell is that noise?
It's a good one. No one just visits Cydonia.
What's the noise?
Nah, you're probably here on business. Am I right? Unless you're visiting friends or family, I guess. Anyway, doesn't really matter. Name's Mitch. I'm just a guy who lives here in the Lux condos. I'm always looking to make new friends. people say I can be a bit much sometimes.
Can't imagine why.
I love having people to hang out with and watch movies, talk about books, play games, or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Hmm. So I'm just having a drink. I'm curious about how much the weirdness goes with him.
Did you forget what you were gonna say?
That's how you spell that. H-N-N. It's cool. I'm happy to make new friends, too.
That's great. You can get a little lonely in Cydonia if you don't know anyone. We've all been there.
Hmm.
Anyway, I don't want to keep you, but I figured I'd ask. If you happen to know anyone with a ship, I've been looking for some help. You can send my way if they want to make a quick cred.
You don't look much like a miner or a marine, so what are you doing living here?
What's that supposed to mean? But just because I look like I couldn't bench press a stick of raw spaghetti, I don't fit in here?
Pretty much.
Nah, just kidding. I got some issues that prevent me from working, and modern medicine could only help so much. I was offered an experimental treatment, and unfortunately, instead of getting cool superpowers, I got more medical conditions.
Not always the way.
But it's okay. They offered me this condo and set me up with enough money to get by without working. I live pretty well, all things considered.
Okay. Why don't you leave Cydonia?
Well, I don't have the kind of money to pick up and leave. And otherwise, I kind of like it in Cydonia. My friends live here. Yeah, I get some credits every month, but I'm no millionaire. Besides, I share my money. I blow it all on games, movies, comics, books, and other stuff for me and my friends. I feel like it's better to spend it now. Create good memories for us.
Yeah, well, that's pretty good outlook to have. You don't get bored without a job to do?
Bored? Are you kidding me? I got more entertainment at my fingertips than I'll ever finish.
Yeah, same.
Even if it takes forever to get to Cydonia.
I don't think I'll ever be bored. And I'm certainly not going to waste my life working if I don't have to.
Yeah, I got a lot of entertainment too. I'm kind of wondering if 2 decades will be enough for me to play most of the games I want to play. Seems like that anyway. Are you gonna be okay here?
I try not to let it get me down. Right now, I'm just focused on living the best life possible. I may have been dealt a shit hand of cards, but I decided to say, screw that! I'm gonna play however I want instead. Though, some things would be easier if I wasn't bound to my home.
You didn't go, well, I wish you the best, then.
Yeah, thanks. You too. Nice to have visitors.
What's there to do around here for fun?
Ooh, yeah. I'm probably not the best person to ask about this. I mostly stay inside. Watch movies, read books, and hang out with my friends. But there's a couple of bars around here. One's for the mine workers and one for everyone. Some people like hiking around Mars. It's a cool planet for that, I hear. People just kind of make their own fun here. New Atlantis, this ain't.
I don't think there's much to see on a hike in Mars. I mean, there's some mountains. I'm gonna try scaling those, but otherwise, it's just a lot of flat red rock and sand, right? So you seem really into entertainment. What do you recommend?
Oh yeah, I recently saw 2 Dates for Darla 4. It was hilarious. Even better than the first.
The way his face changes, like he doesn't really buy it, what he's saying. This is still white, so what else could you recommend?
Return of the Interceptor. It was cool, but I think the series is starting to get old. We'll see how number 8 is.
Number 8. Anything else?
Hey, have you ever seen Das Raumschiff?
Nope.
Everyone says it's amazing, but I don't know. Seemed kind of boring to me. Just goes on and on and on.
Alright. Anything else?
Have you seen the new Norvici movie?
No.
I mean, I didn't like it as much as his last film, but it was alright.
You're talking about all movies. What about these books? What do you recommend?
I accidentally started watching this sports movie because it was on and I was too lazy to change the channel. It's about this underdog team full of losers. It goes on to win the championship.
Bad News Bears?
You know the one I'm talking about? Anyway, it wasn't bad.
For all I know, he's talking about Jerry Maguire, but the first thing that pops to mind is Bad News Bears. Anything else?
The Radical Adventures of Jim and James. Yeah, it's super old, but it still made me crack up. I recently binged a bunch of older flicks from before people left the system. A lot of them still hold up.
Like what?
Oh, there was this live-action movie adaptation of an old animated show. Oh, it was so bad. My friends and I almost died laughing. We had to stop like 3 times just to catch our breath.
Huh. I'm just gonna keep on going, see how much he has to say.
Nothing new. Oh, wait. I saw a movie about this weird bug that looked like a stick, and it danced. Not sure what they were going for, but it was fun.
A stick bug or praying mantis?
I saw a cool horror movie called That. Just That. It scared the crap out of me.
It's probably coming out next year. That's what they did. They tend to, I don't know. Some of the horror movies and thriller movies lately have been getting strange titles.
Hey, are you gonna say something?
No, I'm just gonna sit there and stare at you. What else for entertainment?
Oh, I saw a movie about this magic-using gnome who goes on this grand fantasy adventure and gets into all sorts of trouble. Wish I could remember the name.
I wonder if he's referencing actual movies that we have seen. because I think the Hobbit maybe confused a Hobbit with a gnome, but they're not magic using.
The Radical Adventures of Jim and James.
Oh.
Yeah, it's super old, but it's still making crack up.
Alright, so I pulled the string enough times he's repeating himself. I have a ship, so maybe I can help you out?
Oh, you do? That's great. Well, if it's not too much of an inconvenience, maybe I can entice you to do a favor for me? Please?
Depends.
I found out recently that my favorite book series, Dragonstar Force, had a very limited initial run.
Oh, you're looking for books.
I really want to collect all the first editions, but it's hard for me to get them shipped all the way out here. I already tracked down Volume 1. Could you go buy it and bring it back here for me? I'll pay you back, of course. Plus, you know, extra for your trouble.
Where can I buy books? What are these Dragonstar Force books about?
They're these old science fiction fantasy books about space and good versus evil and a mysterious magical relic called the Dragonstar. Now, there's this team of heroes who fight space wizards and dragons, demons, and whoever else seeks to take over the galaxy using the Dragonstar.
Oh, sure, I could do that for you. Look at them all hopeful.
You will? Wow, you're the first person to agree to do it.
Where do I buy it from?
Well, thanks. Well, like I said, I'll make it worth it to you. You won't regret it.
Where do I buy it from? Buy the Dragonstar Force book.
I have waited so long for this book. A little longer won't hurt.
Okay.
Yep. See you later.
Having a little trouble there, friend? That was way too much fun. Alright, so Media Sponge? Mitch Benjamin has asked me to go get a first edition copy of a book in the Dragonstar Force series from an off-world vendor. Well, I guess it makes sense. And he said he bought the first one. Well, he found the first one, but I have to buy it. Oh, it's on. Wait. Is it here on Titan? I mean, I guess so. That's cool. I wonder if they sell other books. Because I will go to town, you know me. Well, that was illuminating. It's just a bathroom here. Oh. I heard a computer opening up. Right there, huh?
I sure hope this hearing loss isn't permanent.
What?
You can make a real good living working the mines here on Mars.
Sometimes I wish I had taken an easier job.
It all steals. Oh wait, this is a take. Mining Monthly Issue 7. Permanently increases tool grip weapon damage by 2%. I don't know what tool grip weapons are, really. I guess I'll find out eventually.
Mars is ripe with resources, which means there's always going to be plenty of work.
Okay. Well, we crashed twice, so it's been a while. But I still save every time I'm gonna go into a computer. It says it's a minor computer. Announcements. Breaks. Just a reminder to clock out for your breaks and clock back in when you're done. This isn't to keep tabs on everyone, just an effort to get more accurate hourly pay information. Thank you, Tia. Gnome. Whoever keeps reprogramming Gnome to give snarky answers, please stop. It's okay to help improve his responses and other functions, but HR has asked that we please try to keep it work safe, and giving him unhelpful snarky responses makes him less useful. If this keeps up, we'll have to retire him to the scrap heap. Well, whoever I talked to at the beginning of last episode, that's the one who's reprogramming him. Forget her name. Right as you come in, she was there mining. Tool replacement. We're officially out of replacement tools. If your cutter breaks down or seems like it's breaking down, you need to bring it to a maintenance technician immediately for repair. Failure to do so will work against you. Remember, you still need to meet your quotas, but we can cut you a break if you can't work while your tools are being repaired. That's good, I got a cutter break. Happy hour. After the incident occurring after the last employee happy hour, we're going to put all future company-sponsored happy hours on hold for the time being. Aww. On a related note, anyone who finds a glass eye is requested to bring it up and see me at the desk so I can return it to its rightful owner. Thank you. That's a related note? Someone lost their glass eye, like in the company punch or something? Employee of the month. This month's employee of the month is Layla Pulaski. Layla has consistently exceeded her quotas by more than 20% for over 12 weeks running. Please congratulate her on her job. Well done. This month's reward is a gift certificate to Chunks. Congrats, Layla! I just had to do it. Alright, so those are the announcements. And then suggestions. Reminder, suggestions are anonymous. Attachments. Drink selection. Requestion more variety. What does that mean? In the company provided drink cooler. I'm thinking something lemon lime flavored or maybe vanilla. Requesting? Probably more requesting. Longer breaks. Can we get longer breaks? I know the lunch break is pretty good, but 15 minutes for our other breaks is too short. Competitiveness. Some of the miners have a problem with competition. They make bets on who can produce the most ore and things like that. But that seems to lead to unsafe practices and potential injuries. Can we not encourage that? Sounds like he's saying, or she is saying, can we encourage competition? Boring. Can we get rid of whoever's trying to put the kibosh on the fun we try to bring to the job? Making harmless little bets isn't hurting anyone. Lighten up, people. Earplugs. We need earplugs on the miners' quarters. More than one of us snores really badly, and it's hard to sleep. Alright. Oh, they're probably not going to get longer breaks. Kind of doubt it. Alright. Cydonia Community Center. Alright, let's finish looking around in here. Protective equipment required. What are we rethinking? Look at that, it looks interesting. Oh, look, I'm budging the lid. Oh. Okay, I'm just like being crazy here.
Quite enough.
I don't know how to answer that question.
Hey.
Hey, hey.
You wouldn't last a week in the mines.
Oh, you're all hard, huh?
Man, Cydonia blows.
You ever hear about this Heart of Mars thing Layla's been talking about? Layla was the one... Yeah, I think Layla is the one who reprogrammed Gnome.
What? No. She's never told me about it.
Looks like he was about to pull a piece.
Is there some big thing everyone knows about that they're just keeping from me? Probably think I can't keep a secret. Fine! I don't want to have anything to do with their stupid Mars Harp or whatever it is anyway.
Heart. I thought this guy was pulling a piece. The way he just moved like that. So what's your story?
My story? My story is that I don't like people asking what my story is.
You're a problem, child.
I'm just messing!
Okay.
But really, I don't want to talk about myself.
What do you think of mining work?
What? Standing around pointing a cutter at some rocks all day? It sucks, but it's easy, so whatever. Way better than my last job at Chunks, though.
Alright then, be gone with you.
What? You're leaving?
Don't be pulling that cutter on me. I'll slap you silly.
This life ain't easy, but it pays the bills.
I think it's the one we keep seeing. How do you guys feel about having electrical hazards and like right where you would sit to hang out? Okay, it's sounding really suspenseful just being in this room. Nothing interesting in there.
The city of Cydonia is proud to be a pillar of support for the United Nations.
I think I've read that before.
If you wish to sign up for military service.
Spiced worms. I really like this theme. It's really growing on me. Your care works wonders. Let me stomp around. Together we are the United Colonies. Your contribution to our organization makes us what we are today and what we will become. Whenever you donate to our cause, volunteer your time, or vote for our representatives in government, you make our colonies better, and you secure a brighter future for our future generations. United Colonies thanks you for your continued support in securing a strong and prosperous future throughout the settled systems, making better works for humanity. Breadstick. 158 credits. Now this isn't something I can open, I guess.
What's up?
Nothing much, just looking around. Looking for more credsticks. Whenever I see these, I want to turn them. Oh, on the back there's more little cubicle cubby areas. Whatever you would really call it. Got blank post-its just waiting for someone to write notes on it. Stress reduction procedure. Bang head here. Instructions. Place poster on firm service and follow directions in the circle until unconscious. I love it. I love someone you see. Oh. Ship repair fundamentals. The real trick to spaceship repair is to focus on the immediate and pragmatic. To ask yourself, what can and should I be addressing right now to make my ship flight-worthy? Space travel is exceptionally dangerous, we all know this, but focusing on that danger, obsessing over it, helps no one. In fact, thinking about it too much, especially when faced with a malfunctioning ship, can be paralyzing. Just keep it simple and do whatever needs to be done, even if that means using scrap or salvage to keep yourself afloat. So begins Horace Shand's Ship Repair Fundamentals, the go-to book for spaceship repair throughout the settled systems. Finding that should increase your skill in repair, I think. I mean, if there is a skill in repair. Red ping pong paddle. Beer bottle. Crit stick. 154. Oops. Can you stop getting in my way wherever I go? They like those spiced worms, huh? No, welcome to them. Definitely don't want any of that. Unless I need it. Alright, so these little bunkers, all down here. Hi.
Musum?
No Musum. Cora.
I used to think I was Vanguard material, until I discovered that space travel turns my stomach in knots.
But you're gonna say you took an arrow to the knee.
Someday, I'm gonna take this business to the stars and turn it into something big.
What business?
Hi, welcome to Jane's, Cydonia's only 100% independent one-stop shop. I apologize if I'm a little distracted. I'm currently dealing with a little issue, but please let me know if there's anything I can get for you.
Yeah. You run this place all by yourself?
Yep, that's me on the sign, Jane. I operate one of the few independent, non-franchise businesses in Cydonia. I've scrimped and saved for years to build up my little shop. Literally, when I started, it was barely a kiosk, and I was selling loose machine parts, scrap metal, bottled water, whatever I could get my hands on.
Why are we moving?
My hope, one day, is to keep expanding to other planets. I've already got a small logistics subsidiary in the works for shipping cargo.
This is really distracting. Why'd you choose to open a shop on Mars of all places? Well,
lack of options, I suppose. I was born on Mars. I never knew my mum. She left when I was little. My dad took good care of me, but he died when I was 14, so I had to fend for myself. Those years were the hardest. The shop began as a way to survive, and it's been successful, so I've stayed with it.
So I think I'm having a little problem with my booster pack here. Running an independent shop by yourself must be hard work. Maybe I can help with your issue?
You have no idea. Every time I feel like I'm getting ahead, something happens to knock me back down. But unless you're some sort of merc, I'm not sure you can help.
I am. See, some sort of merc.
I saved up to get a new ship and hire a pilot. He was supposed to help run deliveries and bring in all sorts of new goods, but he went missing.
Whoa.
I can't find anyone willing to track him down.
Oh my god.
I'm worried something bad has happened.
Sorry, with the explosion and this thing that happens, it's really hard for me to focus on what you're saying. Okay, her ship and her pilot. What do you think happened to him?
I'm not sure. I'm hoping it's something simple, like he ran out of fuel. It's an older ship, and it may have had a minor leak. But I know there's a problem with pirates out there.
Mm.
This was Eric's first real piloting job, and I'm worried they could tell he was easy pickings or something. Could just be my overactive imagination.
You never know. Why can't you call SysDef or something like that?
If all else fails, I'm probably going to, but I'd rather not. That ship? I bought it from a sketchy dealer, because it was all I could afford. Seemed too good to be true. I'm not sure now it was entirely legit. So, you see the problem with contacting SysDef.
Yeah. As long as you have credits, I'll do it.
Yes, of course. I mean, I don't have a lot, but it's worth it. If you find the ship, I'll definitely be able to pay.
Okay.
I'll try to compensate you as best I can when you bring back Eric and my ship. It's a cargo runner called the Berry Mule.
Berry.
The last signal I got from him was out near Triton. It's a starting place, at least. And try to bring them both back in one piece.
Sorry, guys. Find the Berry Mule. Jane's ship, the Berry Mule, and its pilot Eric have gone missing. She asked me to search their last known location around Triton. Is it you? Are you making me do that for the last 5 minutes?
Careful near the railings on the upper levels. It's a long way down.
You're gonna find my ship, right?
Yeah, I want to look at what she has for sale too, but any other ideas might have happened with your ship?
Not really. Last I know, Eric was piloting the Berry Mule out by Triton.
You could really...
Then, nothing.
You could turn your
head. I know
head.
Pirates sometimes get bold and venture into Sol to hit cargo vessels. But it could be something else.
I mean,
maybe he just ran out of fuel? I don't know. I'm worried, though.
How far can she turn her head?
Yeah, bye!
Only employees of Starfield.
I can't imagine what Eric's going through right now. Sure thing. Take a look.
Okay. So she's gonna turn her head all the way around.